This video will introduce you to the word frequency query. You can run a word frequency query by going to the Explore ribbon and choosing the word frequency query. By default, it will search in all files and externals of the project. I'm going to choose selected items just to limit this to all of the content in the interviews folder. I'm then going to run the query. What NVivo has done is it has identified each individual word in all of those files and then counted how many times they occur. We can see people is the most frequently used word and it was used 155 times. This is followed by east, think, like and just. But we have to remember that I have just searched entire sources, so this includes the words of the interviewer and all of the questions they asked. So I can go back to selected items and instead go to cases, open up the people folder and then tick all of the interview participants. This time when I run the query, it's only counting the words of those participants and you'll notice some changes in this list. Let's look at some of the options in this query in a bit more detail. You'll see that this is displaying the 1,000 most frequent words. It could be that we wish to reduce this, maybe down to the 200 most frequently used words. There's then the option to change the minimum word length. This is set to 3. It would avoid things like to, it and of. Of course, this is dependent on the language. Having the minimum word length set so low for a language like Chinese would severely impede results, so you might want to set this for 1 if relevant for the language. For English, I can leave this at 3. Finally, we've also got the options to group them under different terms based on stems, synonyms, specializations and generalizations. As we've seen in the previous video, this can get a little random, so I'm going to leave this as stemmed words and then rerun the query. It will show you which words it's grouped together under the similar words heading. So for example, the word developments represents the words develop, developable, developed, developer, developers, developing, development, and developments. If you wish to visualize this query, you can click on the Word Cloud tab on the right hand side, and this will generate a visual representation of the frequency. Essentially, the bigger the word, the more frequently it occurs. This makes it an excellent way to hint at quantity without directly applying numbers. This makes it a really popular visualization in many social sciences. You'll also see at the top of the screen, we've got the option to change the visualization using different fonts, colors, and styles of visualization. When you're happy with the visualization, you can right click and export the word cloud, and you have the option to save it in a range of popular file formats. These are great for appending to your research project. You may, however, find that there's some terms that you wish to alter and tweak in here. For example, we might want to remove the word think, just, want, and get. To do this, I can right click and choose add to stop words list, and then OK. And then repeat this process for just, want, lot, and get. You'll also notice it's bringing through all of those stems as well. Now, when I rerun this query, NVivo will completely ignore all of those words that I've just added. It will quite literally pretend they do not exist. So, for this particular query, it won't spot them. But this is really important to bear in mind. This affects all queries and all areas of the project. Now that the word think is on the stop words list, if I were to run a text search query for the word think, NVivo would say there were no references to it in the project, even though it's one of the most frequently used terms. This is because it's on the stop words list. You can edit the stop words list by going to File, choosing Project Properties, and then choosing Stop Words. Here you'll see all of those words that I've added, and if I wanted to remove all of them, I could just click Reset, and it will return them to the default words for that language. It's in here you can change the text context language to bring in relevant stop words for any language you might be working with. If your language is not listed here, you can simply choose the other option at the top, click stop words, and then go to Google, search for stop words and the name of the language, and you'll probably find a list that's good enough to paste in here. You can then click OK and it will apply in the project. In this case, I'm going to switch us back to US English, click OK, and if I rerun this query, you'll see all of those words that I added to the stop words list are now back in there and will reappear on the visualization when it loads. Finally, if I want to explore any of these words in more detail, in this example I'm going to look at the word community, all I need to do is right click on that word, and then you'll see I've got the option for running a text search query for that particular word. As soon as that loads, I'll get the familiar text search query showing me the references and summary for that particular term. You'll notice as this was a stem, it's also included the Boolean to search for both communities and community, so we have it singular and plural. I'm just going to really quickly run one last word frequency query. In a previous video, you'll remember that we created a dynamic set for male and female respondents and interview participants. I can now use one of the dynamic sets for this query. So for example, if I tick female and use that as the selected item for searching and then run this query, the results will give me a list of the most frequently used words by my female participants. After analysing this, I could go back to selected items and switch this to look at the male participants and see if there's anything different. It's at this point it would be really useful to save the criteria so I have both of these queries ready to run side by side.